गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स. सो वी आर मीटिंग आफ्टर वन वीक. हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर फाइन. टुडे वी विल प्रोसीड द चैप्टर, थर्ड चैप्टर इज सीड एंड बीज. इन आवर लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन अबाउट द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ए सीड्स. Today we will see about the chemical properties of acids. First of all, it is reaction with active metals. See my dear friends, many times I used to say in the class that don't get it by heart the reactions, but try to learn the concept. What is our basic concept? Metal plus dilute acid means metals react with dilute acids. It forms salt plus hydrogen. For example, here magnesium, zinc, iron, they all are reacting with acids. And these acids are dilute, are forming salt and hydrogen. Now, we have seen the reactivity series. Potassium, sodium, calcium, these three reacts violently. These reacts moderately. But below hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver, gold, platinum, they do not react with the dilute acids. So, metals only from potassium to lead, they react with dilute acid and form salt and hydrogen gas. Normally we have three inorganic acids, hydrochloric and sulfuric, and third one is nitric acid. We can't use this nitric acid for the preparation of hydrogen gas. Why? Because nitric acid is a very strong oxidizing agent. What is oxidizing agent? We have studied in 8 and 9. So, when hydrogen is formed, once again this nitric acid oxidizes hydrogen and form water. So instead of hydrogen, here water will be formed. So only magnesium and magnesium, here is an exceptional case. Here only magnesium and manganese can react, can produce hydrogen, can react with 1% dilute nitric acid. For example, it is here, it forms hydrogen. One word is here, neutralization. What is neutralization? See, any acid reacts with base, it forms salt and water. For example, if it is HCl acid, when it reacts with base, it will form salt plus water. This is our, once again, it is our concept. The acid reacts with base, forms salt and water. Now, we were thinking about what is neutralization. So a reaction, chemical reaction between acid and base, a chemical reaction between acid and base is called neutralization reaction. A reaction between acid and base is called neutralization reaction. So, reaction with base means acid neutralizes base to form salt and water. Here this is, these two are acids, these are bases. react for salt and water. Now, here is action of dilute acid on salt. There are many types of salt. Some salts are sulfate salts like calcium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, chloride salt, calcium chloride, magnesium chloride, zinc chloride, carbonate salts, calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate, sodium carbonate, bicarbonate salts like calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate. So here, what are the acid properties? When acid reacts with a bicarbonate salt, so it will decompose. It will form these products. My dear students, once again, I would like to remind you, don't go it through heart. Our concept should be, I am giving you 2-3 concepts. Students, here are some concepts. NEM stands for metals. Any metallic carbonate, when reacts with acid, it forms salt, water, and carbon dioxide gases evolved. Similarly, metallic carbonate like zinc bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, reacts with acid will form salt, water, and carbon dioxide. Likewise, metallic sulfate like calcium sulfate, iron sulfate, zinc sulfate, metallic sulfite, zinc sulfite, iron sulfite reacts with acid. They form salt, water, and sulfur dioxide. Metallic nitrate, lead nitrate, zinc nitrate reacts with acid. It forms salt, water, and nitrogen dioxide is formed. Likewise, any metallic sulfide, zinc sulfide, iron sulfide reacts with acid. It will form salt plus H2S gas is evolved. The smell of H2S gas is just like rotten smell. Now, this concept you must write somewhere in your book or copy to keep in your mind. These are the basic things. Now we will come to know about the chemical decomposition. Action of dilute acid on salts. So when the bicarbonate salts like or carbonate salt like calcium carbonate or calcium bicarbonate, it is carbonate, this is bicarbonate, when reacts with dilute acid, it forms salt, water, and carbon dioxide is formed. Just right now I had given you the concept that metallic carbonate, metallic bicarbonate reacts with acid, forms salt, water, and carbon dioxide. Here is one important note. If the salt produced is insoluble, if this is insoluble salt, then the reaction does not proceed. So we do not expect lead carbonate. Lead carbonate, it never reacts with hydrochloric or sulfuric acid. These are the some exceptional case. Then, another one is hydrogen carbonate means hydrogen carbonate of sodium and potassium. Hydrogen carbonate means sodium bicarbonate and potassium bicarbonates are the only metallic carbonate, common carbonates, which exist in solid state. Now, I had given you this one. When metallic sulfite and bisulfite reacts, they produced salt, water, and sulfur dioxide. Here is sulfite or bisulfite reacts with acid, produces salt, water, plus sulfur dioxide. Here is the example. Then, when acid reacts with metallic sulfide. Just right now I had given you the concept that metallic sulfide reacts with acid, forms salt plus hydrogen sulfide. For example, here zinc sulfide plus acid, it forms salt plus H2S. The smell of this H2S is just like rotten egg. Then here is reaction with chlorides. How the acid reacts with first chlorides. Here is barium chloride. When it reacts, it forms HCl plus 1 insoluble salt is formed. Few chlorides react with dilute sulfuric acid and dilute hydrochloric acid. Now nitrates, same thing. Only a few nitrate like lead nitrate reacts with dilute acid, whether it is sulfuric or hydrochloric, it forms nitric acid. Means when nitrate salt react with acid, it forms nitric acid and insoluble precipitate is formed. Babu, here are some reactions. These reactions we will study once again in the chapter of hydrogen chloride. Normally what happens, chlorides like sodium chloride, nitrates like potassium sodium nitrates, means metallic chlorides reacts with acid. Metallic chlorides reacts with acids, it forms bisulfate. Here one acid is formed plus one salt is formed. These are the basic concepts. These reactions, at least this and these two reactions, we should keep in our mind. If you see, both the reactions are same, but what is the difference? That in this first one, this sodium chloride reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid below a temperature of 200 degrees Celsius. Then bisulfate is formed. But when the same reactants, if it is heated after, means above 200 degrees Celsius, different salt, here is sodium bisulfate, here is sodium sulfate, is formed. These two reactions will come once again in the chapter of hydrogen chloride. How hydrogen chloride gas is prepared, we will see it in that chapter. And this one, these two will come in the chapter of nitric acid, how the nitric acid is produced. Here are some examples of acids, boric acid, citric acid, this and that. And here are its use. Boric acid, sometimes tears comes from the eyes, sometimes we feel burning effect in the eyes. We dissolve some boric acid in water and we wash it. This acid acts as antiseptic. Citric acid, food preservations means the food which we prepare today, tomorrow or the day after tomorrow, it will get rotten, it will be putrefied. But this, if it is used, it can be used after, even after a few days, weeks or months. Oxalic acid, we know it is just like water, it looks like water. If we write anything, there will be a mark, there will be a stain, stigma, daag lag jata hai jaisa likhte hain. But if we put one drop, it the color of the ink will be removed. So it is used as this one. Carbonic acid for the flavored drinks. The cold drinks which we use to drink, it is made up by sugar, water, some fragrance, some flavors. Plus, before packing the bottle, this carbonic acid, carbon dioxide, in fact, it is pass into the bottle at high pressure and forms carbonic acid. Here, like this, water reacts with carbon dioxide and it forms carbonic acid. It is very weak acid. So this carbonic acid is used for making the soft drinks, flavored drinks, cold drinks. Tartaric acid for baking powder. मम्मी घर में बनाती है खाना ना, तो दे यूज दिस पाउडर, बेकिंग पाउडर. एसेटिक एसिड विनेगर इन कुकिंग. इवन द पिकल्स सॉस व्हाट्स एवर वी यूज इट इज मेड अप ऑफ टोमेटो चिल्ली सॉस मेड अप ऑफ चिल्ली द सेम चिल्ली इफ वी यूज एट होम After 3, 4, 5, 6 days, it will get rotten. But even after few months, if we use, why it seems to be tasty? Little amount of acetic acid and this benzoic acid are used. The purpose is, once again, to preserve the food for a long time. Hydrochloric acid, all the time, hydrochloric acid is produced in our body. That hydrochloric acid helps us in the digestion. Now, here is one word, pickling, cleaning of metal items. So, suppose if it is iron, we have to coat it with zinc. The coating of iron with zinc is called galvanization. So, before coating of zinc, there may be some rust, there may be some metallic oxide form on the upper layer of iron. So before coating, we pour some this dilute hydrochloric acid just to remove the dust. This process of removal of impurities, metallic oxides before galvanization is called pickling. Nitric acid, it is used as explosives, TNT, trinitrotoluene. In preparing that trinitrotoluene, this nitric acid is used. Phosphoric acid, in the fertilizers. My dear students, some of our students must be coming from the farmer's house. They will be knowing what is fertilizers. There are different types of fertilizers which is used for the cultivation of the crops. If we use this one, we will fertilizer. If we use fertilizer, more and more crops we will get. So phosphoric acid, this phosphoric acid is used to make fertilizers. So my dear students, it is for today only. Next day we will start the same chapter, we will continue the same chapter, but our topic will be different. It will be now bases. We will start base. This is for today. If you have any problem, once again I am reminding you, you may be getting some problems in online, but to clear your doubts, you are very humbly requested to make a contact with your teachers. Wish you all the best. Bye.